Hello everyone and welcome on De Papier de Rêve channel. I'm Ursula and today I will be painting with you some cactuses, the same as last week, but this time I'm at home and I all the time to do them quite in a different way. So last week I was at the cactus garden and I paint some cactuses, and this week I'm painting the same cactuses but with a little bit more time and with all the learning I have from my previous experience. I will use what I've learned in this painting to make them a little bit better and maybe a little bit different, we'll see. I'm starting this painting by adding some shape of cactuses with nickel as a yellow, mixed with a little bit of yellow ochre, because I want this yellow to be a little bit more warm. And I've started with this color because I want my cactuses to be very bright, very yellow first. And I've noticed that when I work them at first at the cactus garden, I've started with the green and I introduce the yellow after the green. And I think it's better to start with the yellow in order to have some brighter color there. I've worked the ground area with some orange tundra. It's a little bit the same as the green tundra that I use for the cactuses. It's a very granulating color from Schmincke. It's a new color and I really love this range of colors, the tundra range. They are really beautiful color with beautiful granulation and also some really neat color dispersion on the paper. So it's a perfect color for the ground and I mix it with a little bit of yellow ochre in order to give this color a little bit more depth and sensibility. And also with a little bit of indigo in order to have some shadow in this area. So I let this layer dry totally, and now I'm adding some first details in this painting. And as you can see, my first layer is really, really messy. It's just colors and shapes that are not defined at all. There is a lot of blurriness in my first layer. And I think that is something that can make the beginner in watercolor a little bit afraid of, because there is no definition at all in the first layer, and it's quite hard to wrap your head around this procedure. But you really have to trust the process and to trust that the layer after this one will add some more details, some more definition into your painting. The first layer is just here to get the right color at the right place. There is no definition at all. But there is a lot of expression, there is a lot of texture beginning to happen on the first layer. And you just have to trust that the second layer, as we work with a lot of transparent color, will make things really better. So I started this second layer by adding a lot of indigo in the background. In the previous version that I've painted on in the cactus garden, I didn't paint a background at all. I kept it quite light, but I wanted to add some dark background here because adding some contrast and darker color around the cactuses will make them more light, will make them more vibrant, and that's what I want. And now I'm starting to add some shapes and definition and depth to the cactuses. They are overlapping each other quite a lot. So I need to find some area where there is some darks. I have to construct, build the texture of these cactuses. And for that, I'm still using the same color, the tundra green, which is really, really granulating. And it's made with an earth pigment. So you can see that in some area, it appears a little bit more earthy. And it's really a beautiful color. And before this color is totally dry, I will add some ground color next to it. in order to ground the cactuses into the soil and make them just belong to each other. And for the ground color, I'm still using the orange tundra. I'm adding a little bit of transparent red oxide and a little bit of indigo into it in order to get some darker shade, in order to have some shadows into it. And I build this ground with a lot of texture because all the color I'm using are really granulating. And I think that now you can see the cactuses emerge on the paper. You can see all the shape overlapping each other. There is a lot of green and yellow into it. And things that are starting to be a little bit more clear, I think. I still add some shadows into the cactuses in order to make them even with more depth. And I continue to build the shape of these cactuses. And for that, I'm using the tundra green mixed with a little bit of indigo in order to get a darker shade. I will let this layer dry totally and I will talk you through my supplies. For the brushes, I'm using a Nescoda Ultimo half an inch and a Nescoda Ultimo number 10 in a dagger shape. For the colors, I'm using nickel as a yellow ochre, tundra orange, tundra green, transparent red oxide, and indigo. My paper today is from Arches in Hot Pressed. For the last layer of this painting, I will focus my work on adding some details here and there, and I will also add some more depth and some darker color. I will build the contrast a little bit in order to make these cactuses pop a little bit more. I'm starting with this dagger shape and some nickel azo yellow, and I try to still build the texture of the cactuses a little bit more, and I add a little bit of transparent red oxide here and there so that the color is a little bit different everywhere, and that way it will appear a little bit more natural. I'm working these details with this dagger brush. I really use it with no pressure at all in order to have the finest line I can with this brush. But I still try to be a little bit expressive with my brush. I do not want something too realistic here. I just want to build a texture that will make you think about cactuses. Here, I want you to have this feeling of cactuses, this feeling of warm day. I want you to see the sun on top of the cactuses. I want you to feel the dryness of the weather. It's all about sensation and not at all about details and realistic details and botanical painting. For the last touches, I'm adding some shape in the background that are really blurry. You cannot understand fully what it is in this background, but I think it helps to give some context to the painting. There is something happening behind those cactuses. There is an environment around them, and I just want you to have a feel for it. And I still want to build a little bit more the contrast between the cactuses. So I'm using some tundra green mixed with a little bit more indigo this time in order to have a darker green here. And I try to not blur too much those lines in order to have a little bit more texture and some more decisive marks on the paper. And my painting is almost finished. It was very interesting to work this painting just after painting the first one in the cactus garden, because I've been able to learn from my first version of it and make things a little bit better this time. And this video is now ending. Thanks for watching and I hope you like it. Please check the blog post for more information about it, and of course tell me what you think in the comments. See you soon.